Let's follow the 3 R's: reduce, recycle as much as you can. Reuse. Hey y'all, the topic for the day is pain in the arse cricket team. Yes, we are going to see about the controversies revolving around the Border Gavaskar Trophy of 2021 and the incidents in the third test match in Sydney. Okay, touring any place outside the country for a test series is not easier, and especially down under, Australia and New Zealand is not an easy tour. Especially the Aussies, where winning only matters. Doesn't matter how it comes. You can win by hook or crook or sledging or hammering or whatnot. The spirit of the game is being dampened. For such a talented side like the Australian cricket team, the incidents like the monkey gate, which happened in 2008, and the sledging incident now, and the controversies around tampering, ball tampering, or unsportsmanship act that has been enacted by the players of the Australian cricket team for whatever reason, despite being the champion cricket side. No, in terms of talent, the Australian cricket team is no match. They are a talented team, but I don't know from where it stems that they should always win at any cost. Doesn't matter how they win, and the spirit of the game is not being followed. This happened in 2008, and this has again surfaced in 2021. There seems to be no change in terms of the change in players. So it's not a player's mentality. Though we talk about the Tim Payne sledging Ashwin, well, Ashwin and Vihari were trying to show some kind of resilience to save the blushes, saving a series. So it is the Australians who had to try different things in terms of their cricketing talents, introduce different bowlers or try something different in terms of what you can do round the wicket, or giving ball to a batsman, part-time bowler, who could do some kind of magic, induce a false shot. And the kind of words used for sledging and the psychology. Why do you do all this? What is the need? Tim Payne was an accidental captain. He became captain because of some unwarranted incident like this. And he became captain because he was deemed to be a good guy. But behind the stems, on the last day, he proved he's not one. He's a typical Aus cricketer who wants to play mental games because they think the mental conditioning is better than all other teams. Thanks to Ashwin and Hanuma, who kept their cool to save the match. Mr. Payne, you'll have to understand the pain you have induced on others. No? It's not about talking, mate. You'll have to play. You'll have to exhibit your talent. It's a space for your cricketing talents rather than your sledging talents. Tim Payne was already penalized for the showing dissent on the same test match, and the frustration has got better of him, no doubt. But as a sportsman, you need to control your emotions and you need to focus on the game. Yes, apologized for his leadership wasn't good enough. Thank God you have understood that your leadership was not good enough. And the pressure of the game has got into him, it seems. How could pressure of a game got in? Definitely there is a problem with your leadership and you need to work on it. Thanks to the stump microphones, for what you are doing. You were an accidental captain because of the sandpaper gate. Why, otherwise Stephen Smith would have been the captain. But despite all this, you haven't learned the lessons. Not just Tim Payne, the whole Ask Cricket team, they think winning matters and only winning matters, no matter how it comes. And these change of moods can happen to any human being. Why is this called a gentleman's game? Because you are supposed to be in control of your moods and your frustrations, and only the cricketing talent has to come. Smith, who had problems with the sandpaper scandal and who was dropped from the team, he was rubbing punts markings of the pitch with his boots. I don't know what is happening to him. Lessons are not learnt, and the Aus team continue to behave in the way they used to behave. And my God, what are you going to do with all your records? You are a bunch of talented cricketers who could sledge, who could do anything to win a match. It's shame. It's definitely shame. Unless somebody from the, I don't know, maybe they lack mentors who could guide them to play a fair game and teach them sportsmanship. With the injury-prone Indian side, we don't know whatever could happen in the last test. But every time I think any team tours to Australia, they are going to have some kind of bitter experience like this because of the attitude of the Aus cricket team. It's not just definitely Payne, it's the entire team. It's not about the leadership, it's about the way they have been groomed. Everyone should take responsibility. Those now sitting in the commentary and commentary box, who have become commentators and who have become legendary cricketers, they need to tell. But even during their playing days, they were like this. So hardly anybody could help them out to change their attitude. That is the problem here. Okay. It cannot be just seen as a joke, because what you have done is not going to give you a good stand during in the history. Aus team is a pain. It's not just one pain in the Aus cricketing team. Cricket has been termed as gentleman's game for some reason. But when it must have been named much before the Australian team entered the game. Australian team is never short of controversies, and wherever they go and whatever they do, they end up in controversy. Be it touring the apartheid South Africa, or when it comes to the umpiring decisions, or whether holding to the spirit of game, or when it comes to sledging players, or you have had used some banned substances, or you have been part of the Sandgate or Monkey Gate incidents, which were staged in a very planned manner. Even before the truth starts, the word of mouth action begins. Not the cricketing action, but the word of mouth action. But definitely, all these doesn't indicate that cricket is anymore a gentleman's game. And all the attributes should be, though it is universal and it has been contributed by many teams, the lion's share has been contributed by the Australian cricket team, and that has to be admitted. There is no denial that history, Australian team has always been among the most controversial team, because more than the spirit of the game, winning matters there. Win at any cost. You are groomed as a pack of hunters who could only come out with victory. And if you lose, you are done. That is the kind of attitude and grooming with which they are being sent into the international arena. And it's not easy to get into an Australian cricket team. It requires a lot of effort and talent, and you need to be exceptional to get into the team. And after getting into that, you could do anything to win a match or a series. The 2008 Monkey Gate, I cannot forget that. How can that be forgotten? When even before the two started, there were talks of whom to be targeted. They always target the best batsman or the best bowler of the opposite team. And I don't know for whatever reason, why should words begin before the cricketing action? And that has made this gentleman's game, that has undermined the nature of cricket as a gentleman's game anymore. And Aussies have contributed it to it and enabled it. Not just Aussies, other teams have also had their part. But with their planned campaigns to establish themselves as more victorious in terms of their mental conditioning, they are not living up to the spirit of sportsmanship, spirits of the game. And that has led to the downfall of what was once termed as a gentleman's game.